हेलो गाइज, वेलकम बैक। टुडे इज 92nd डे ऑफ आवर 100 डेज ऑफ चैलेंज ऑफ एडोब एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू मेक दिस। सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। सो हियर वी आर इन आफ्टर इफेक्ट्स। एज यू कैन सी आवर template here, you can see layers, too many layers I have worked on, but I am not going to show the whole process because it's too long process to show each and every, because the process I have used in is the same which I have used in before tutorials, in our previous tutorials. So let's get started for our tutorial. So firstly I will replace my logo here. Not actually necessary, but I'm going to just show. Okay, let's put this logo here for now, just for now. Okay, then yep, let's leave it for now. So I'm going to tell you how here it is an animation workflow tutorial, how I have done it. So firstly what I have done, as you can see, this is our main one folder in which I have downloaded the file, vector file from FreePic, in which this, all of these things were. It's all a vector in which I have created this one on different layer, the ground on different layer, and the temple on different layer. And so I had done what, I pre-composed the temple in which I have again created three layers, one for this flag, one for this flag. As you can see, I have animated, given a simple flag motion to it, so look it something natural. And then just I have color corrected it, given tint effect to it, and how I animated this, the main process here. This is the main layer. What I have done, I have applied puppet pin tool to it. You can see here are all of the puppet pins. I have applied one each for the joint and just given a simple motion for the neck coming back and dragging. You don't have to click on the keyframes each time, just add puppet pins and just go some frames ahead and just change your pins like this. It's going to animate. So just a subtle animation I have done. And for the cloth here, what I have done, I have just animated it in 4 frames. Like at this frame the position is same, at this frame the position is same, different, and at this position I have changed the position of pins. Just a simple animation. And what I have done, just select it, Control C, some frames ahead, Control V, same done for all the way up to your composition. So what next? Let's minimize this. And what I have done, I have taken the arrow layer on different and just created a shape of leaf like structure like this, as you can see, like this, and applied wave warp to it. Not too much height but too much width, because we don't need too much waves, that's why. And just duplicated this layer couple of times, 2 times, and just changed their color. Nothing extra, and this is our shape. And what I have done then, just animated its position. As you can see here, the arrow goes flying. I have just animated its position. Here is the position, animated it going forward. going forward and just scale it little bit lower like this. As you can see, I have changed its scale little bit lower. And for this arrow, for the string of the bow, you can see what I have done again. I have just created a shape layer, just a shape layer selecting pen tool, just an outline from here to here. And what I have done then, just I have created it with 3 points, just 3 points, 1 point here, 1 point here, and the last point here at the end, and just animated it manually. At this frame, the center point is at here. Then I have just changed its point. As you can see, we have only 3 points, and I have just changed the point position, and just to give to a flexible effect to it, just animated it front, back, again front, and settle it down to give it more natural effect. So this was our main composition first, like this. The background is also from the same vector file. It is free to download from Freepik. Then what I have done for the Ravan, this is the Ravan I have created by watching some references, too many references, because I haven't getting a nice one for my video, so I created by myself. What I have done, as you can see, I have created this one layer main, then I have created this small hairs in Illustrator as well. You can see it's a Illustrator layer, this small hairs, and these the eyes on different layer. Same for this one also, I have used puppet pen tool. For here also you can see puppet pen tool, same for the joints like this here, and just added some more for the cloth. And same here, animated the, you can see this is the cloth points, just done for 4 frames, and just select it, copy paste ahead, so it will give you a nice cloth flowing motion. Same method, and I have just animated the hands here little bit. You can see I have just changed the position from here to here, like this. He is taking his hand up, a nice subtle animation like this. And what I have done for the eyes, I will show you. I have just scaled it just a little bit. As you can see here, the value is changing. I just squeeze it just a little bit to give a effect like he is looking upside while laughing. And for the ears, this one which I have created in Illustrator, the small ears, just applied wave warp to it. Same height is a little bit low, width is too much. And another, the big ears, you can see here I have put them into pre-comp because they were too much, like this. These are, each layer is different, each layer is shape layer which I have created, just like this. Big ears strands, and just animated wave warp to each of them. Same effect is applied to each of them. Just select it, search for wave warp, and just apply it on it. Or you can just do one thing, just select one layer, apply the wave warp to it, then select all of the layers and copy the same effect from one to all of them at a time. So the hairs are done, and just select, I have created one side, then duplicated the composition, right click, transform, and flip horizontal, just flipped it horizontally on the other side. So you can see both of the sides have same animation. So for clouds, what I have done, I have created a shape layer let's just isolate it for now. You can see it's a shape layer. Just I have created random circles, just dragging all over, just doing randomness, random circles all over there. And then I applied some simple choker to it to just merge all of the edges, like here, to make them smooth just a little bit. Then I applied vector blur to get some natural organic type blur. Then I applied bevel alpha to get a little bit shadow or highlight, to get little bit highlight from here. And at last I applied wiggle position directly to it. You can see here is the wiggle position, and just amount, decrease the amount to 20, and just duplicated that shape layer, scaled it and put it behind, and just make the apply tint and make it little bit more darker. So that's for the Ravan in background. So the main two animating things are done. Next thing was to create fireworks. So creating it from scratch, I think I would use my own fireworks, which I've created something 2 years back. Yeah, if you haven't watched that video, you can go on the channel, or I will just, you can just click on the I button in the corner for that. I have created this firework effect just I think two years back. I have created this. I have also put the whole tutorial how to create it, and I have just exported that firework on black background, so I can make its blending mode add and use it simply. So I have just drag it here and duplicated it couple of more times, because as you can see, we need lot of much fireworks. If you are going to create it directly in this composition by Trapcode Particular watching the tutorial, so it will take too much hard of your GPU, because you need too much of firework. So I will prefer you can create the firework on different After Effects file, export it in green screen or just like overlay map for this in black background in video file, and just drag that video file into your composition. It will help you a lot, because it's too much firework here. As you can see, it's video file, then it is also lagging too much. So what I have done for this explosion of the Ravan, I have dragged the Ravan composition here, and when I want to explode it right here, what I have done, I have duplicated the Ravan here from here directly, and drag all over the composition, start to here, and applied grow bound effect, because I was going to apply shatter effect to it. And if you know which we have created the shatter effect tutorial for the text, shatter text, if you know the shatter effect, just apply wherever your composition bounding ends. So my Ravan composition was just like this. So the if we off this, you can see the shatter effect is ending here, but I don't want to end here, so I add grow bounds and just increase the pixels to 1500, so our shatter effect is lasting for long, up to till end of your composition. And what I have done in shatter, applied shatter, I haven't changed too much value, just change the repetition and the pattern to glass, and just the extrusion depth to 1, and at last increase the gravity too much, up to 15, so that it seems like the particles are falling too much faster. And as you can see, the fire, like little fire effect with the fire effect is also falling with it. So I duplicated the same shatter effect composition one more time, and just I have done one thing. I have applied Gaussian blur to it a little bit more, 78%, and applied a tint map just with orange color, as you can see. And note one thing, just do the blur dimension to vertical, it will give a falling effect like this, Then I have created the fireworks. As you can see, the little firework things are going up. So what I have done for it, I have make a trapcode particular file. You can see there is a trapcode particular applied on it, and I haven't changed any of the value here. Any of, I just go to effect builder and just I will show you. It will take too much time like this to opening, that's why I was avoiding. I have just one thing, open your trapcode particular, go to presets, and just I have dragged a preset from here. You can see you can get fireworks directly from here, but I'm not little bit satisfied by these fireworks, so I created mine. And I just used this one vertical fireworks and applied it without changing any of the values. Just change one thing, the color over life. Just I have changed the color over life, and after doing that, same, just duplicate your fireworks little bit more and more like this, and as it will take hold up your sky, what I have done, a new text layer, or you can say a logo or anything if you want to add. It's a Marathi language. Yeah, I know it's a Marathi language. I have just done one thing, select your logo, go to layer, auto trace, select alpha, and just select the tolerance to 1 and hit OK without apply to new layer. Don't check it, keep remain it unchecked, and just hit OK. And just I have applied saber effect to it, and in core customization, here in core customize core, I have selected layer mask, so our saber effect is applied to layer mask, and applied energize effect it and decrease its intensity. And now we have like a after firework thing glowing in the sky, and as it, if you know, saber animates the glow and flicker effect to it, so it's looking nice here. After that, I have added these leaves. If you can see, we have added these small leaves here. So what I have done for it, same trapcode particular effect, and again not changing the values manually. Just I have done one thing, go to effects builder, open your presets, and here you can have, let's see where is the thing, organic matter, and I have chosen these glowing maple leaves. And just done one thing, in sprite I have added my own sprite. From here I have added my own sprite. If you don't know how to add your sprite, so just click on this little icon here, blocks, and just click on your add new sprite and select your PNG layer. Confirm that your layer is in PNG, and I have just selected this layer and just hit OK, and you are done for the leaves. And I have just the F, if you can see, our whole workflow of wind is in this direction, and that's why I make the velocity in minus, so it will flow in same direction of the wind. So that was for the leaves, and just I have created two layer of leaves, one behind the our main character and one on top of main character. So if then we have like little bit depth effect, and then I have created the leaf, the main leaf. This, for this I have worked too much hard. I have just tagged my the same leaf here, and then what I have done, I have just animated its position manually like this. Each frames, if you need like this, applied it manually, applied motion blur it to it, like from here applied motion blur. And also I have animated scale. If you can see, there are, I have added some rotations to give it like effect like it is rotating. And at last I have added my logo, not this one, the other logo I have added the logo. Select your logo equip tool and just equip it to the your leaf. I have done that, and so your logo is now going to animate with the leaf. And for the logo, if you can see, you can have a little bit 3D effect on the logo. For that, I have used Bevel Alpha with 180 degree light angle, and thickness is just 5. And just applied color vibrance for that. For here, I have given a tint effect to it. For now, that's it for today, guys. Hope you had learned creating this simple. Not simple, I'm not going to simple, it's just a long process. It is simple, but it is just a long process to create. So I haven't created a nice big tutorial, it will be too much big. So I have created just this workflow tutorial, workflow animation video. So don't forget to like the video. If you are new here, be sure to subscribe the channel. So guys, let's meet tomorrow again. Till then, stay safe, take care, and keep watching the channel. And happy Dasera again.